Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the webinar about the news of similar extended products. Instead, Abacus, Tosca, FSF, and iSight. So we'll see all together during approximately 1.5 hours some news about this project. And we'll try, well, of course, there are a lot of new things, and we have been obliged to make a selection. But it may be very interesting to see all of them. And for the other one, do not hesitate to take contact with us in order to explore and to find what you may have missed during this new release. So the content about this presentation will be very simple. We'll begin by some presentation of the team, but you know this. And most of our presentation will concern, of course, Abacus, which is the main product and the product which has been the more enhanced. But we'll also have some time for Tosca, the conceptual optimization software, FSF, fatigue simulation software, and iSight, which allow to capture a process and to deal with optimization, parametrical optimization. Now, so I am Sylvie Bujas from Kyonis, which is now a member of the group CINIT group. We are everywhere through Europe in 10 agencies, present in 6 countries. But our mission did not change with the incorporation into CINIT. It means that we are always there to provide you advice. It means to listen to your needs, to propose you some adapted solution. We are also there to train you and to provide you adaptive training. To support you, that means two things. If you meet defects, non-defect behavior with your software, but also to develop with you the methodology applied to your job. So I would like about the contact that you notice that our corner of the coordinates, and above all that you may remark, you may notice that the form of friends support has changed. This is particularly interesting since the last one was overtaxed, which is not the case of this one. So please enjoy it and do not hesitate to contact us if you need to. Now, just to be clear, we will have one legend. We use some flags to identify the evolution, the enhancement through the product. The red flags indicate new functionality, while the blue one indicates only enhanced functionality. Wow. You may also have a list of the release information of the new enhancement in the site which is indicated on the slide, and also on the documentation of the project that you may have downloaded first. We will deal with the product of extended token solution, so it means Abacus, iSight, Tosca, and FSafe, which may be conjugated to get the best of all of them. Just notice that if the new version happens to be very late in February, the first hotfix was very early after, and we advise you to download it and to install it because it solves some minor bugs, above all if you are using iSight. Okay, so please update your function, it will be a gain for everyone. Now, we will begin by Abacus and first by the graphical interface, CAE, with some enhancement. So the first one concerns unsorted node sets. normally it is node sets, but now you may select a new category of node sets by checking the on the interface as a make unsorted set. In that case, it allows you to select the node quite differently. First, you are almost obliged to choose it individually or by face, but now you can also choose it by along geometric edges and in order. So order is important. You may also use it by free picking, of course, but you can also use labels and even exploit Python expression to take the labels automatically. So it's very convenient. And you have this sort of graphical interface. You can see it on the right of my slide. And here, it's also possible to edit it directly to add some lines, to remove them, to change a number. So to adapt it quite easy. It seems, okay, just one trick, but the application may be interesting also. For example, node sets allow some freedom when you try to define constraints of type equation. So first, if you, I don't know if you are used to, but when you were defining constraints of equation type, you have this sort of graphical interface. On the first row, you define one set name, which could contain several nodes, but from the second row, each set could only contain only one node. Okay, this restriction is not any more valuable since with one unsorted set, you may contain more than one node, as much as you want, and you can add several rows with a different unsorted set. But one restriction remains, since if you use several unsorted set nodes, okay, all of them should have exactly the same number of nodes. That's the constraint. But anyway, it may allow to define equation a little bit more easily than before. Now, another application of this unsorted node set is when you define a path for viewing the result. By the fact, the unsorted node can be used directly to define the path. It's quite convenient compared to select it node by node manually. The second enhancement in Abaqus concerns the board loading process. I don't know if you are familiar with this one, but you have a screw, and when you want to preload it to model the preload of the board, it was possible, but not always intuitive to manage. Now, when you define a board load in the load module, you can directly select the board shank surface and the cut position. And as you can see on the picture, you can define automatically where the cut should be. So it's very easy and much more intuitive. Furthermore, if you do it on a dependent instance, it can be applied in the path such that every instance will have directly the good setup. Now that's very interesting. Okay, the axis is naturally defined, and you can also check the pretension section and apply it directly. So once again, it's quicker and above all more intuitive. Now, a new predefined field type has been defined. It's the field one. Just in order to make things clear, remember that when you define materials, materials property may depend on temperature and also field. Now, this is what you can manage with this field, field value. So with the predefined field, in the initial step, you can define initial condition, but in the other step, you can define the change of state. And like temperature, it allows you to make evolve the properties of the material during the simulation. So that can be very interesting if you want to take that into account. Before that, you were obliged to use the keywords editor, or even use a subroutine, but now you can do it directly with the interface, which is very interesting. For the one who are formed with the cut-based free-body forces, now it has been extended to composite solids. Of course, it provides you some average data, not ply by ply. It would have no sense, but it may allow to use this representation if required. If you use XFEM, you may see that sometimes the enrichment zone was a little bit large, and now it can be minimized to avoid some propagation not expected. Just take into account that it works even if the mesh is modified. Another possibility deals with the element type that you can define by default. What does it mean and what is the aim of that? It means that, for example, if you are used to deal with incompressible materials, you may prefer use hybrid elements. Now, by default, Abacus never proposes hybrid elements, but if all of your calculations are about it, wow, you may oblige Abacus to propose you, by default, the hybrid element. This is something you may describe in the Abacus environment or the custom V6 environment file. Okay, so it allows you to make things easier when you are doing some repetitive sort of calculation. Now, some maybe details, but sometimes very interesting as well. So the limit of the number of characters of the name has been updated to 80 characters in the EMP file. First, it had been done for part instance in the last version, but now it has been extended to every name. Notice also that the method to query the angles has been homogenized and generalized. Before, you were obliged to use in the CIE 3 points, and in the viewer, you were obliged to select element faces or edge pair. Now it's possible to use both of the two versions in each modules. So enjoy and use the method with which you are the best. Now, another detail, but when you want to print a picture in a file format, the default format is now PNG and not anymore PostScript. For people who are used to deal with user subroutine, file extension are different if you use Windows and Linux. Now it can be both .f or .4 for the both environment. Easier to migrate the solution from one OS to the other one. I don't know if you remember for the change in Abacus 2017 about explicit dynamics, but a new stable time increment method had been proposed. And this method tends to propose one larger time step than the traditional method. It was also the default new method, but now The change is it's not the default method anymore. Okay, so the default method is the traditional one like before. One last point deals with the multi-scale material modeling, which will be developed in the material part, but concerning the scripting. Some scripting support has been added in the documentation to allow you to develop your script about these functions which are in large development and large interest. Okay, so that's the first summary about the Apache CIE announcement, and now we will pass to materials. There are several announcements. We have only chosen two of one, which are considered like the two most important, but some other subjects may be interesting, like enhancement in thermal expansion or towards the super elastic behavior. Well, since we have to make some choice, we may advance with this one. So, multi-scale functionality is largely in development and more useful, more and more required. So, the system makes a lot of work on that point, and they add, above all, a new homogenization approach, including a direct merit and account homogenization, in order to be able to model multi-phase composites and additional element support. Okay, so you have some new keywords, some new functions which have been added for that, which are much quicker and much more adapted. So just for the example, you may have a result from injection molding with fiber duration. Now you import it into Abaqus, and with the homogenization, you will have easier behavior to treat the calculation, but after you will be able to get the output at microscopic scale. Notice also that thermal loading is now possible with multi-scale functionality. For large deformation, the orientation has been updated such that it follows now the deformation gradient instead of the rotation of the element like it was before. So the result is much more physical and should be provide you best result. Notice that the method FEAVE is now validated by one test with a perturbation state realized with a six load case. After you have some over output which has been provided in order to check micro level results, like for example the equivalent plastic deformation. And the documentation has been also updated in the manual verification and, like we said, in the scripting verification to make things easier. Now, some other enhancement has been provided, like new inclusion shape, the possibility to solve heat transfer problem or Cooper temperature displacement, damage failure, and some bugs have been also fixed in order to provide you a reliable result. Okay, the other part we wanted to explain concerned two new user subroutines in explicit, Abaqus explicit. So the first one, VU-MAT-HT, allowed to define thermal constitutive behavior and internal heat generation, okay, as function of position, time, temperature, density, thus to provide you a more advanced behavior. The second one, V8-VAL is only dealing with each generation of material, so it's a little bit more limited than the first one. But it allows it also easier to implement into your program if you need to. Another generality which is not really materials but which concerns analysis and I'm actually explicit deals with the importation of model data and results from over analysis to a new one. Okay, so now it's possible to have one analysis one analysis two, and you import the results of the first analysis and the second analysis into one third one for two different parts, for example. So this one is now possible. We have some restrictions. Of course, the last analysis has to be accurate explicit. And the former analysis, which provide the results that you import, have to be from the same type, either implicit or explicit, but not one mix of them. And since we are speaking with Abaqus explicit, let's see what the system has reserved for enhancements. Now, it begins with two new elements which were existing in Abaqus standard, but which are now available in Abaqus explicit. The first one is C3D5, linear pyramid, and C3DH4, tetrahedron, which is interesting for uncompressible results since it is a hybrid element. As you can see on this one, there is one comparison of the results, and you can the left one and the middle one are the same results. One is in implicit, the other is in explicit, and you see that the results are a little bit different but very close for the same formulation. Notice that the fact that the same element exists in the both formulation makes easier the import since it is the same element. If you use the non-hybrid elements, the result is particularly degraded and much more difficult to interpret. Second point deals with a Lorentzian boundary condition. In fact, if you consider CEM solution, so remember that it is contact with coupling Eulerian Lagrange simulation. So here the fact is you will have a new boundary, Eulerian boundary, which will have simultaneously inferior equal to none and outflow equal to none. This means that from this boundary the flow can neither go out or enter. And it means that it eliminates normal component of the velocity to only allow sliding velocity. This behavior is not supported by CEE as you are obliged to pass by a keyword editor. But anyway, let's see what it can provide for results by comparing two modeling. So if you take the right one, okay, with the CEA contact, which is indicated there, you have a solid part there, and the fluid, which is flowing there. Now, in this one, you will apply a Eulerian boundary condition and see how it works. So let's see the video to see the difference. Okay, notice that in this model, we have now represented the solid part here, which is important for the contact. Now, in fact, the boundary condition prevents the fluid to go out, so the contact is not is represented by this way. So the results are quite similar, not exactly the same. As you can see there, that if you take the contact into account, you may have some separation between the Eulerian material and the solid, which is not visible there, since of course you have no contact, but just for binding to leave this part. So it's not exactly the same thing, but of course it's much more economic since you don't need to have solid parts and of course solid meshed parts. Pay attention to sharp corners where this sort of boundary needs to be used to prevent flow leakage. Pay attention also to the change of direction of the normal to be sure that the behavior is correctly represented. If you use now SPH simulation, some new Eulerian conditions have been developed, like inlet and outlet, which allow to generate most easily the particles and to inject them into the fluid. So as you can see, the video there, it provides you very, very easiest simulation, simple to represent and to interpret. Furthermore, it's much easier to set up, which is the best point of all. Okay, now we will pass some time about linear dynamic enhancement. And they have a lot to say. Of course, we have shortened the results, but we'll speak about all of them. Now, maybe you know the MS solver used to solve eigenvalues problem, and above all, in frequential extraction analysis. So, just remember something if you are not used to deal with it. Usually MS is much faster than the block transverse eigensolver. And the difference of velocity is above all concerning large scale analysis of millions of degrees of freedom and thousands of eigenmodes. Furthermore, scalable hybrid implementation has been developed. It means that we can make parallel calculation, but also exploit, use the fact that we have some GPU on our station. So that makes things much easier, much quicker, as we will see that. In order to show the performance of the MS, when calculation has been provided, and here you can see that the test selected here has 38 million of degrees of freedom with 4,300 eigenmodes, which is quite a lot, and even in Habitus 2017, it was not enough to make it run. But now it works with reasonable time, I mean. Here we have two colors. First one is the standard calculation, and the red one is the MS. So, understand by standard Lanczos, block Lanczos calculation, and MS in the Lucera. So, as you can see, the difference of time is noticeable. Now, if you add CPU and GPU on your station, you may use it to make things even quicker. So beginning of use of the GPU has begun in Abacus 2016, but it has never stopped to enhance. And now we can see the results that we get. So this is one example of a structural acoustic car modeler. Okay. And as you can see, lot of information to use. Now, here are the results in time. So several configurations have been compared. First, of course, we are used several calculations with several CPU. Okay, but also we make, so this is a color which indicates the number of CPU. Now, you have also one average position, which is related to the number of GPU. So you can see that the most important difference separates without GPU and with one GPU. And here you have a really important decrease of the wall time. After, the effect of the number of GPU is sensitive, but not as much that the GPU effect. And this effect is not only valuable in model solver, but also in full analysis. If you use, like in the former example, acoustic structural simulation, you can now specify viscous and structural damping for acoustic material. So, notice also that this behavior may be temperature dependent and that in Aracus standard. And also that you may use piezoelectric damping if you deal with such sort of phenomenon. Concerning the energy, history and field output have been enhanced to provide you more information and to allow you to analyze more easily the different calculation by linear dynamics. So, for example, you can see there difference of energy through the time or through the frequency to check the difference of damping, different effects. And you can also have output, field output to see where is focused the kinetic energy, for example. Now let's speak about substructure, dynamic substructure. Aracus also supports some workflow with several popular multi-body dynamic solvers. So you know certainly some of them, SIMPAC, ADAMS, EXCITE, and also DIMOLA, which can also make that sort of thing. You have different formats of flexible body, which can be used that way, and all of them are generated by a Aracus to allow the coupling of the solutions. So the typical workflow is use Aracus to generate flexible body entities and recovery matches. Then Aracus has a translator which allows to translate the flexible body entities and to translate the recovery matrices, which are implemented into the multi-body solution. Now, to make things easier, some things have been adjusted. For example, the maximum structure size of the substructure has been multiplied by almost 3, which allow to create more important substructure. Notice that the size is defined by the retained model degree of freedom and the generalized degree of freedom associated with the substructure. Notice also that this large substructure are usable by the other solution like SIMPAC or ADAMS or EXCITE or DIMOLA, but not for Aracus itself, which is only restricted to 16,000. For EXCITE or ADAMS, it's also possible to use reduced formulation. So in that case, you will have less precise results, but more lighter substructure, which make calculation quicker and easier. Now, in fact, the workflow has changed with the search source function. First, you have Aracus standard, which will generate flexible body and recovery matrices, of course. Now, the translator translates flexible body entities, but not the recovery matrices. The flexible body is sent to the dynamic solver, which will solve the generalized displacement, means the displacement in the model space. And after that, only you will use the recovery matrix to transform the generalized displacement into physical results. and thus you can visualize it in a matrix. So this new approach allows to spare some time on the beam recovery matrix translation. So it avoids to duplicate the data for recovery matrices, which is very important for this space, or when you have very large substructure. And the results average can be covered at the element vertices and the intermediate point for the high order element. So it means that in the middle point of the element if required. Here you may see some results, what you can obtain from the selective substructure recovery. We may also have some words about the translator to output 2, which is one output in the NASTRA system. And in fact, it has been enhanced above the shell element to take into account the normal behavior about it in bending behavior. So the results have been changed in order to be much more in correspondence to what was expected by a NASTRA user. After that, we may speak about interaction, contact, and constraint, and we will focus on three particular applications. First, the 2D fluid pressure penetration. Okay? If you consider a second 2D model, so as we have here, you may have two phases into contact, and you apply fluid flow duration. In the former version, the pressure was applied, of course, on the free surfaces, but also on the contact surface, which is not necessarily corresponding to really, because it implies some leakage in the pressure, some penetration. So now the new behavior is only focused on the parts which were free and not in contact. But it seems like no change has been done to 3D behavior. The second large enhancement concerns the feature edge criteria in dynamic simulation. Means that when you consider edge contact, the former solution were not already accurate or did not provide the wanted result. So it has been improved to take into account the large change of geometry that you can observe on some short problem, like for example airbag analysis, where you have a lot of folding and unfolding region and when we have a very flat initial situation. So you see that the edge changed a lot of geometric configuration, and so it means that we have to reactualize the way of dealing with the contact. The new version of algorithm makes it much more robust, accurate, and with good performance. So let's see what it does impact. You can see on this flat paper, which becomes more and more folded, you can see that the percentage of edge active in contact increase through the simulation. So the idea is to use only the necessary edges and not all of them. And you can see there that the performance of the new algorithm in terms of times with a general speed up noticeable. The change is due to edge enhancement with dynamic criteria. Let's explain how it does work. So you can implement it with a keyword interface. And you have two new world keys, which are original and current. And original is the default value, which corresponds to the former behavior of Abacus, because it requires less resources. And current indicates that we should apply dynamically feature edge criteria, and it means configuration by configuration. So this one is more accurate, but of course easier in terms of resources. Now you have also parameters which concern which are criterion for the application of those criteria, and the edges and the angles of this one. Consider, for example, that you have a very small angle. Okay, in that case, you have a very small chance that the edge enter into contact more than the face. Okay, so the contact is driven by the faces and not by the edge. But if the angle becomes more and more important, in that case, the edge can become more and more important also. So true edge allows to have one inactive part and one mid part before taking that into account. So this is the aim of this double criteria. So of course, results show that the second algorithm is much more efficient and very good results, but also slower, because of course it requires more time considering it deals with more data. You can see one effect in solving that sort of contact transition problem. So here you see that how it is dealt with. Only one simple contact, and then it passes to contact with a lot of shanks. So results can be seen there in the distribution of force. You can see the difference between prior version treatment and the new one, which looks like much more physical. A new enhancement deals with the friction coefficient. Friction is always something which may be a little bit complex. Depends on a lot of parameters, but above all, the nature of the materials which enter into contact. So we have to take that into account to define the new friction coefficient. And this is what is proposed in this function. So you may use combinatorial rules to define a local friction coefficient function of the material which enter into contact. So here, you will use function. You can define friction coefficient, of course, by material surface, you were doing before. But you can also define it like property, and you see here for each surface, you define one number of friction, which you can find here. And when they enter into contact, the function will be calculated to have a good behavior. Above all, you can also impose for some part some special local or global function which will be prior to the calculation. So you can really adapt now the friction simulation to what you need. Okay. So let's see with the event. We retain only 3 points of the element. So the first one deals with the continuous solid shell element. Maybe you remember that this new element has been introduced in Abaqus 2 from 2017. It's 3D continuum element for thin structure application and was suited for composite solid, but it's 3D materials model. Now, there was something which was a little bit doubtful, it was the orientation which were not projected onto element mid-surface for regular brick elements. So now, the orientation is projected onto the element mid-surface in the initial configuration. So it allows to have local material structure direction normal to the element mid-surface. After that, of course, it may change more only if you have a geometrically non-linear analysis, and here it will rotate with the average material rotation. Recalculation of the initial normal facilitates also conversion from a continuum shell element to continuum solid shell element. Okay, a new element has been also realized for heat transfer. It is a DC3D8R. This element is a linear heat transfer bridge, but the new thing is here, reduced integration and hourglass control. So it allowed to decreasing quite a lot the weight of the calculation, since you have only one integration point instead of eight. So you can see there that for benchmark analysis, the calculation time is decreased by one factor of 1.5. A new element has also been developed for gasket elements in order to take into account the coupling between temperature and displacement. So for such analysis, new elements have been developed. You can find there the name and the formulation to see what can be provided with that. Here, as you can see for the results, you can also have the temperature and the displacement as usual with brick element for thermocoupled structure, but now it's also available for gasket element assumption. The last point with Abaqus deals with Tosca integration. For one who are not familiar with that, just remember Tosca is conceptual optimization software, and common well-known application is topological simulation, topological optimization. So, in fact, the idea is to integrate always better Tosca inside Abaqus, because now you have a module to Abaqus which is called optimization and which allows to launch calculation of Tosca if you have the corresponding token. So, how it works, Abaqus computes a primary solution, okay, as well as design response and sensitivities, and Tosca will read them and carries out the design optimization. It chooses the strategy of optimization. It leads it. Now, the number of design iterations to satisfy optimization criteria are done, and the validation can be carried out totally in Abaqus. The performance has been increased considerably from 2017 from 2016, and once again in 2018. Let's see that these techniques are also applied directly in the 3D experience for the GDE application. Now, since we began with Tosca, we will now develop more precisely what happens inside. First thing is very important to Tosca user. The lean sensing based on the FE design FlexM vendor daemon is no longer supported. So please, if you are using FlexM with Tosca, just take contact with the technical team or your sales contact in order to see how to organize the change from FlexLM to DSLS, because as it has been announced last year, it will replace it, if I understand. Notice also that the all similar Tosca structure driver has been deactivated. So now you have to use a new driver Tosca Python, but if you use with Abacus, it will enhance the performance. So should have no regrets about that. The integration with Abacus has been, like we said before, enforced thanks to the Tosca Python driver. And it serves also the performance using Abacus MPI for the parallel calculation. So it makes things, once again, quicker and easier. For more complex tasks, or more general tasks, some new sensitivity has been developed. We calculate now sensitivity for fatigue, thermal, and NVH, so for the noise design resistance. So these new features allow to enlarge the application field of Tosca and conceptual optimization. One of our things allow to create design response as a mathematical combination of design response from different steps. So for example, you have two road cases, and for the first one you have one displacement, and for the second one another displacement, and what you want to decrease is the sum of both of them. So you take the sum of the displacement, and now you will work on this one, not on all of them. So that may be interesting. So of course it may be an aim, an objective. It can also be a constraint. Since topological optimization finds an application in additive manufacturing, Tosca has a new sort of constraint, which is to restrict the overhang angle in optimization. So as you can see, it allows to avoid to have a very sharp very large angles, which are inappropriate to use support structure, and thus even in additive manufacturing, the design is not feasible. Okay. So this is once again an improvement linked to real application. So if you use additive manufacturing, consider this point. The documentation has also been improved by adding some guidelines and checklists to help you for nonlinear optimization. You know that Tosca allows with Abacus to realize topological optimization and others by taking into account geometrical material and compact nonlinearity. Okay, so but these problems are always a little bit tricky, so it may be sensitive to your problem. And the aim of the documentation is to provide you one guideline, one checklist in order to aid you to realize such documentation, such simulation, such optimization. This is the most point important. It may be difficult, but with a good guideline, it may make things quite easier. So we will repeat never enough that use the documentation, you will find very, very useful tricks. If we consider shape optimization, so it means that here we deal with the displacement of the node of the surface in order to usually smooth the stress. The fact here we want to impose a new restriction to prevent the nodes to pass through the surface. So here you can block the displacement of the node with the surface, but you can also block it only in one sense. So as you can see there, some nodes can't pass because they are under the surface, but if they are above, they can go through. So that's a way to block things and you can adapt it to your problem. If we consider now sizing. Sizing, in fact, consists in optimizing the thickness of shell, most usually, and also the diameter circular bin. So, in fact, some new functionality has been added. First, you can add some constraints on the stress, and also take into account nonlinear effects like plasticity or large deformation. We have here some examples. So this is the result. This is before optimization, and this is after. And the legend corresponds to the thickness of the shell. Now these troubles can be done by taking into account frequency, but also plasticity, kinematic coupling, and things like that. Now you can also use sizing with a lattice structure. It means with a lattice of beams. Okay, because sizing can also play on the diameter of the beam. So here, if you consider the structure, it can be calculated and take into account the nonlinearity. So it allows to consider plasticity, nonlinear kinematics, even bulking, if it happens. Just one word for Tosca fluid. Okay, Tosca has a structure application, but there are also fluid optimization, and this in that case we will work on the optimization of the flow, okay, in order to remove the losses. In fact, the difficulty was to work with a separated design space with disconnected flow paths. And the disconnection came, for example, because you use a component like fan between both of them, and usually the flow is just cut and has to be reinitialized. So before, you were obliged to define a total design space with a frozen part in the middle, and now we can just treat it separately. On general point of view, some upgrade has been done on the solver interface, and of course, Tosca has been developed to support Abaqus 2016 and Navcam 2016. It's also the case for EFISAFE, which has been actualized for 2018, and for Tosca Food, version of Start SMB. If you were surprised not to see ANSYS in the structure and Fluent in the solver, it's linked to the fact that the agreement has not been signed and thus development has not been done. Well, this is all for Tosca, and now let's speak with EFISAFE. Okay, once again, several development, and we will just focus on some physical one. First thing, maybe one best thing, concerns the installation. By the fact now, the installation of EFISAFE is totally integrated into the installator, contrary to 2017, where it was necessary to install it before. So now, everything is in the same installation. Easier, quicker, safer. You have to notice the removal of ANSYS because agreement has not been signed like it was for in 2017. And also due to delay of renewal of the agreement, actually, Altair and solution of Altair and PTC are actually removed. Hope it's only temporary. Let's notice, of course, EFISAFE supports the latest Abaqus ODD, so the ODD of Abaqus 2008. If you use plugin loading in algorithm, for the algorithm, it's easier to load than now. And thus, you are even able to use more than one plugin in the same project. Now, last year we spoke about Verity, which is one add-on of EFISAFE, which deals with weight fatigue. Okay, so this one has also been improved to face the application. One of the enhancements is also the compatibility with NASFAN and the use of the fastener element C-Weld to model the weld. You can also notice that in the main menu, where you add one item variety, it has been changed to one weld preparation item, which is more intuitive for user. You may also combine SN and TN curves in a single material since the version 2017 Hotfix 4. Now, last point concerns the theoretical of critical distance algorithm. Just to recall, notice that if you consider like where and all, the apparition, the initiation of the crack is linked to the stress which is observed at the boundary of the ore. But the propagation of the crack, which will damage your structure, is linked not to this one, but on the stress gradient close to this one. So, in fact, we will check the value of the stress at one distance, and if the stress is above the threshold, it means that the gradient of stress is uh, is not large enough, but so the stress remains high, and then the crack will propagate. So this algorithm has been changed in order to be able to include shear stresses and not only normal stresses in the calculation. Now, last but not least, with EyeSight, what does it change in 2018? Well, let's see that. First thing is the development of high-dimensional scatter bubble graph. So the point is to be able to represent, to plot some value with a lot of input. For example, the results depend on the space, but it wants to modify it, to discretize it, to be able to see it more clearly. So you can also play on the color of the results, of the side of the symbol, and also of the type of glyph. So if you use three of them, you may add some three dimension to the readability or to the interpretation of the plot. This is the point. So, just select bubble graph, and then you will be able to choose some other results and to associate itself to color, to size, to shape, to provide a more complex representation, and then to embrace the results at just one size. So here you have one example with two functions on that one. It's mainly the color which change above all. But here you can see that here you have the color and here this is a symbol, but not only the symbol but also the size. Okay. So it provides you other way to interpret the results. DOE for algorithm has been also a new algorithm has been developed for that. EyeSight has a lot of algorithm about DOE, but it may happen regularly that sometimes you have begun to make some analysis with one DOE, but it happens to be not enough, not useful, and you want to complete it. And this DOE will be able to take the first results of your first DOE, or your just first results, and to complete it with a new DOE. So it's easier with that way. Suppose that you have the blueprint from first calculation. And now you see, you observe that it's not enough to calibrate what you want, to determine clearly what you want. So we have this adaptive DOE algorithm. EyeSight will find the red point which will complete the plan using the former points. So like that, you don't need to do it again, you just add and complete your data. Another thing is towards the error handling. Until now, if something goes wrong into one component, for example, one calculation doesn't work, all the process is stopped and all the optimization is stopped and you have an error message, but you can't do anything for the next time. The idea is to use exception model programming and thus say, okay, if you need an error, notice that error and continue as if the error was not here. So it's matter of exception that you can meet in Python programming, for example, but from some other software. And the idea is this one. Okay, we may have some error code, which is reference, but the process is not blocked and the optimization can continue. An enhancement has been done on error analysis graph such that the data which were not disponible from mouse pointer are now actualized to make things easier in the interpretation. Concerning components, of course, the components of Abacus have been upgraded to be compatible with Abacus 2016. In fact, Insight 2018 is able to support Abacus 6.14 through Abacus 2018. Same thing for Catia V5, but you have to notice that the component is enhanced to support Catia V5 R26 until R28, but the former version from V5 R25 are not supported anymore. This is important. And you have exactly the same for SolidWorks. So, earlier release on 2015 is dropped. Jaito, which is the scripting pattern for Java interfaces used into Lightside, has also been upgraded to Jaito 2.7.0. So, in order to have something updated. The same thing has been provided for Oracle Base, which is passed to 12T version. Okay. And the SEE has been also improved to get better stability and reliability by the calculation. So notice that some bugs have been opened with the Golden Age version, and once again, we recommend you, above all if you use iSight, to use the Hotfix one to solve those bugs. Okay, so now I finished the presentation, and you may have some questions if you had any. Do not hesitate to send it by picture. And even if you have no question today, do not hesitate to contact your technical support if some release or something interests you and that you want to have more explanation about it. So we'll remain at your disposal and try to bring you this new support, this new skill, and to allow you to improve again and always your simulation. So thanks for having joined this webinar. I hope you found it interesting. I hope I did not fool you with so many information. Anyway, do not hesitate to ask if you need. We will have pleasure to be contacted by you. So have a nice day and see you soon.